between 64 and 68 to 19, around 1980. Now, from a boomer's perspective, many of us boomers will call all of these Gen Xers and Gen Ys or millennials sweet young things. Okay? And we have a tendency to lump you all together. But the reality is you're very, very different. And we'll be talking about it. Xers are skeptical, and I use the term brutally honest. Who thought that they were brutal? What generation? The boomers, exactly. And the Xers said, I am so tired of playing all those politics. Can't we just say it? And what did the boomers think?
No.
No, it's rude. It's not appropriate. So again, I want you to see that. So I put brutally honest. Very self-reliant and very pragmatic. Boomers will say, Xers will say, give me the bottom line and I'll figure out how to get there. Don't micromanage me. Right, Xers? Okay? You'll see a difference in a minute when I talk about the millennials. Xers want a lot of, and I want you to see this piece, usable training, something they can use outside of their junior league world. Okay? If it's going to be worthwhile, it's going to be something I can use in other places. They're techno-literate, okay? Technology is important. And here's a big piece. They equate structure with bureaucracy. Why do we have to go through the process? Can't we just come up with a product? And Gen X would rather simplify rather than complicate their lives, and they're looking for return on investment, which is why it's so important, particularly for your Gen Xers, that you say what you've learned as a result of this placement to make it work. I want to get us to our millennials.